Hoodrich Radio is the voice of DJ Scream Moran. What's up?
What's
hey, to celebrate the 2-year anniversary of Hoodrich Radio on iHeartRadio, it's only right for the one and only Gucci Mane, aka the Trap God, to be up in the building, man.
Thank y'all for having me. Glad to celebrate with y'all.
Now, can your chain get any icier, man?
It can't.
It can't.
You can't.
Are you going to get to a point where, like, you've done the Dalmatians, you've done the Bart Simpson,
you've done a lot, man.
You're going to get to a point where what do you do next, man?
I don't know. It's a hobby of mine. I don't think I never get bored like making.
You never get bored? Do you dream stuff like when you sleep about chains? Like the next
I
one you
be making
get?
Little inventions in my head. Sometimes I feel like I be shooting bricks too. I might come up with an invention that don't even be that dope. I'll do that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Word.
Yeah, that's what it is, man. So how's everything just been for you? I mean, obviously we can see it's been amazing. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like it's almost like you become a new person, but we know that you're still Gucci. We can hear that in the music. You know what I'm saying? You elevated your career to a level like never before. How you feeling?
I'm feeling good, man. I'm glad that I'm at this place in my career, man.
Mm-hmm.
I can be be a man and an artist that I'm proud of. So I know that all the people that I inspired, all the artists I work with, all my young partners who seen me come up and I helped them, I know they're proud of me. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I'm being somebody that I'm proud of.
Word. Absolutely. We had TM88 up here not too long ago. He said that he said you inspired him to work out.
He said when you went to jail, he was skinnier, and then when you got out, it just flip-flopped.
Yeah.
And he became big, and he came to your crib to work on some music, and you was skinny, and he was big, and you was getting up 6 a.m. hitting the treadmill.
I was telling him. Even the other day, like, me and Quay was in the studio. Now, like, whoever next day, I'm like, let's go train. You think he takes back? He takes back by the studio, but he was like, man, you got time for that.
Yeah. So
you try to involve, it's always good to inspire your partners, but at the same time, it's like, with me, I always try to share whatever I got with everybody around me. So it's like,
true story.
Man, if you right next to me, I'm going to be like, man, I got a trainer pay. Might as well work out with him too.
Yeah.
It's just how I think.
Do you feel like, though, but some people just got to make that change when it's time? Is no matter how much you tell them, it's just like
want something for somebody, they got to want it for themselves.
Mm,
like facts. A lot of time, I feel like I probably try to force stuff on people because I'm just so excited. Like, bro, you should try to, follow what I'm doing and, probably work out better for you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when people come to me with their problems, I try to, do what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess it'd probably be better if you just live your life and inspire people by them watching you
instead of
preaching to them.
No doubt. Now, you hold the world record forever for how many artists have got put on. You've put everybody on.
You got the record.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
As you move forward, well, first off, name some young people that you think is hot right now that you rocking with.
21. Thug.
Mm-hmm.
Quavo.
Mm-hmm. Okay. They all on the album, right?
Take Sit. Okay. Young Boy.
Mm-hmm.
Pablo.
Yep.
All the A-Town, Future, Lil Baby, Lil Got It, Lil Key.
Where do you find your music? Does Gucci Mane just wake up and go on the internet and listen to music? Is that what you do? Or
honest,
you hit in the club or what?
To be honest, people be turning me on and stuff.
Okay.
Oh, just wow. Like with y'all, I know people be like, bro, somebody, have you heard about him?
Mm-hmm.
Or then, I go to the club and then I got... To be honest, like me and my partners, man, we really love music.
Mm-hmm.
So even my partners, they always telling me like, boy, you ain't heard Young Boy, you ain't heard this, you ain't heard that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, man, people be trying to they don't give me a chance not to hear nothing. They always telling me what's hot and what's popping and, put me up on game.
That's what happens when you're the trap guy, man.
Yeah.
Everybody.
So that's our thing. That's how we communicate with each other. Like, you heard about this, you heard about that. You know what I'm saying? You laid on this. So I put them on stuff, they put me on stuff.
Word.
Okay.
So when you look at Zone 6, all the stars that's come out the East Side, how does it make you feel personally?
Man, I'm loving it. Word, bro, yeah. That's the biggest thing. We really running the rap game.
Yeah.
All jokes aside, yeah.
Yeah. And if not just running it, we're making a big impact. And I feel like, man, we deserve it. It ain't easy growing up in East Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously.
Mm-hmm.
So to see what Future doing and to see what 21 doing, and, I'm proud of them.
Mm-hmm.
100% glad that I can be a part of it. Like, glad that we... people following our footsteps, loving what we're doing. We inspired a whole bunch of people to try to imitate us.
Mm-hmm. Now I got a joke, but it's serious, man.
Yeah.
I think it's time for Arthur Blank to sell the Falcons to Gucci Mane
too,
and
please.
Make it the East Atlanta Birds.
Yes.
We gave them enough time to get the championship.
You think I'm playing?
I think it's time to sell.
This serious. I asked one of my closest partners, my homeboy Todd. I was like, listen, I got all this going on. I'm trying to quadruple my net worth. Like, within the next couple of months, he was like, you need to get into sports. You need to try to get into getting a team. He was like, you can do it. He would see, I'm like, you think I should really try to get into it? He was like, yeah. That'd be a fool not to link with you. You on the rise.
It seemed like the Hawks do better when you at the games.
I agree.
They 100% do. Anytime I go to the game, everybody start
balling. They try to show off for Gucci. Yeah.
They do.
Seriously.
They do. And they don't go just for the Hawks. They go for when I pull up to my partners on the Celtics. They go to when I go to the Heat games.
Mm-hmm.
When I get there, man, they start trying to do 360s and all kind of jumps.
All this Gucci. What was it like for you proposing at a Hawks game?
Man, that was dope. That was like something I never forget.
Mm.
You know, it was special, but at the same time, man, you know, it took a lot. I'm glad the Hawks let me come perform because they didn't even know what I was trying to do. That really was a surprise. So
yeah.
I feel like I pulled something off that was like totally something I never would usually do. People don't expect me to, like, I maneuvered that on my own. I felt like I accomplished something.
Yeah. So how did you deal with the critique that came with it? Because a lot of people say you just put a ring in her face and was like, here.
I don't know. Just so much in the moment, man. You know, it was going so fast. I wasn't even thinking about it. You know, to be honest, it was like a blur, dog.
I dig it.
I promise you.
I take your word for it, man.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, you've been putting up hits, man. You've been on the charts. You got this record with Bruno Mars going crazy. Shouts to
Thank
Kodak.
Mm-hmm.
The joint, I Get the Bag. Like, it seemed like when you got back to it, Gucci always had the biggest record in the streets for sure, right?
Mm-hmm.
But now you're on charts, like the top of charts. How does that feel?
Oh, man, it's very, I'm happy, man, for that, honestly.
Right.
I came out with, from both to I Get the Bag to,
Black
you know,
Beatles was the first number one you was on, right?
With somebody else, but still I had my own number ones because I had both. Then I Get the Bag, and now I got this. So I'm like, I ain't even been out 3 years, and I got three. Then I had Slippery. Then I had the Black Beatles. Then I had the Party record with Chris.
Yeah.
So within 30 months, that's I had 6 or 7 number one records.
Wow. Congratulations.
Yep.
Wow.
Thank you.
Wow. So we know that that's good to you, but as a person that worked with you before, do you ever miss the mixtape game a little bit?
I do. Yeah. I do. And I look at me in my prime, my more prolific years.
Mm-hmm.
And I was crushing them. I was working so hard, but you know, I wasn't, my life, it didn't match. I thought I was balling. I was balling out of control, don't get me wrong. But it's like I was working so hard, but you know, it's like I'm working smarter now.
Word.
That's the best way I can
And he's
do.
Always had the work ethic. When he called me to do Gucci Sosa, it was 7:45 in the morning.
Mm.
True story.
Gucci Sosa is one of the hardest tapes ever.
It is. Scream, we're dropping
Even
tomorrow.
The cover
the
so
cover
dope.
Was crazy.
It's the hardest cover ever, man.
Ask me, you told me, we're dropping tomorrow. Pull up.
Whether it be a Gucci right, cool. Sosa too.
I would love to.
Come on, Scream.
We need to do that.
I'm here. Hey. 10 toes.
We on record. We on record.
10 toes down.
We can do that tonight, man.
Oh.
Hey. Oh, what? Oh, hey. Book patchwork.
Hey, let's do it.
Book patchwork now.
Hey. I just need some beats on it. Hey, shoot.
Hey, man, do you think we ever see, like, any type of So Icy reunion? So Icy Boys, OJ, Walker, anything? Like, songs,
man, you know,
tours?
I'm happy for everybody. You know, I wish that everybody, I'm glad that everybody's successful and everybody making money, but honestly, I don't see no So Icy reunion tour.
Okay.
It's not nothing that I want to be a part of.
Got you.
Honestly.
Got you.
That's what honestly, it is. Yeah.
That's what it is. So moving forward to the new album, Evil Genius. Everybody always says, this is my best body of work. This is my best album. Yeah. How does Gucci feel about it?
Man, I feel like, to be honest, it's kind of like, it's the record that I always wanted to make. I always wanted to get in this zone.
Mm.
You know, like, when I used to be stunned and I used to have, like, my Hummer and my Vet, and I thought I was crushing everybody, right?
Yellow Vet.
So I used to always get, like, Birdman albums. Mm. And people be like, man, Birdman don't be flowing like that. But I always get, like, Fast Money. Whatever Birdman put out, he'd just talk about stunning through the whole album.
Yeah, yeah.
So I feel like that's what this album is now. These are my albums where I just, you know, I'm rich, I just kick it.
Mm.
You know, it's like, if you don't get it, you don't supposed to get it.
True. You making it for who you making it for.
Straight for dope boys. If you don't like it, you don't even got it. I don't even care if you like it.
Yeah.
I'm already rich anyway.
Yeah, I mean, those people that
I just keep feeding the people that I want the music to be. It's like, you know, you make music for just your partners in the studio.
Yeah.
I feel like now I just make the music for me.
Mm.
If you like it, you like it. If you don't like it, then, you know, so be it.
Mm.
You play it, so be it.
Mm.
I went through all that trying to make you like it.
Right.
Now I'm like, shit, you don't like it? All right, cool.
Yeah.
I ain't tripping.
Yeah.
Rich anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
What's one of the things you would want to say to some of the young boys out there in their teens in the game, trying to get in the game, going through the struggle, might still be in the streets?
Tell them, man, you know, just like take everything one day at a time. And be, I always say this, be grateful for what you got if you get to get some more.
Mm-hmm.
If you working a job, be grateful for that job. You know what I'm saying? Hustle that job while you trying to be a rapper.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like if somebody helping you, if somebody like supporting you, or you know, like me, I always had people like help me, even if it was Zay or HB or just my crew going out with me. You know, I was so grateful for them. You know, it's like, damn, y'all coming out with me. Y'all putting the shirts on with me. And we going and do this free show. They ain't had to do that. I guess I was so grateful for everything that came my way. I was bound to get more.
Absolutely. Does Gucci have any regrets? Like, do you regret anything for your past up to this point?
Well, I regret a lot of things I said about people, you know, hurt their feelings and stuff like that. I regret that. I wish that I, you know, didn't say things that I said. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Gucci Mane, we read the book. And thanks for the shout out in the book. I appreciate it.
Number he was geek for like a week, bro.
I was.
He was geek for like a week.
Right here. I carry that little man Gucci. Show me. See, I know Gucci. See?
That's hard. That's hard.
But I feel like on the big screen, a Netflix, anything. We don't want
to
call it.
We're going to do the Netflix. See, my book was already, the rights to the book has already been bought by the same people that put out The Negotiator, American Gangster, the Founder movie about McDonald's.
Okay.
Nice. Those same people are going to put out the Gucci Mane movie. And I ain't even 40 years old.
So are you going to have any say-so?
Well, ain't no Netflix special. We going to the theater.
Oscars. Gucci trying to get an Oscar.
100%. And I'm definitely one of the executive producers.
So you going to... Gucci, Denzel. That's what I was going
to
say.
I'm trying to say I need the young Denzel. Because
you want young Denzel? Right. His son?
Yeah. Or something like that, yeah. If he dope. You definitely can get a tryout, you know, audition.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. We appreciate you pulling up the Hoodrich Radio, man. Let everybody know that they can stream this album everywhere, all streaming platforms.
And
before
everywhere.
We get out of here, what's one of your favorite records on here that's dear to your heart?
My favorite record probably be Bipolar featuring Quavo.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's like me and Quavo, we make so many records. It just was natural, just organic. And I look at it like one of my little brothers, so it just it's a special song to me.
Looking at the Migos, man, would you ever, because remember that studio was you, Migos, Pee-wee, I think Dolph was pulling up.
That's why I'm the evil genius, man, because I seen all these boys, man, like,
Thug,
man, when they was like early on, I seen they were stars. I treated them like stars.
You did.
Before anybody even knew who they was.
You did.
You know what I'm saying? I opened the door for them, man, I treated them like equals. I knew they were stars.
Mm.
And now I feel like, damn, I was smart. Look at what's happening now.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Salute to Gucci Mane for pulling up the Hoodrich Radio.
Absolutely.
96.7 to be. Go get that evil genius right now.